Today's video is going to break down some Draft Champions gameplay for you guys. What's up guys, my name is Cody Bauer, and here we're going to be bringing you a video today talking about the Draft Champions game mode, and we'd like to go through and look here at the coach. When picking the coach, the main thing you want to look for here is what kind of playbooks they've got here. I'm going to go with Joe Philbin because he's got the spread offense with a 4-3 defense. My primary defense this year is from a 4-3 type of set. Offensively here, we're going to look at the picks here. And I think that I think that wide receivers are really important this year to have good receivers that can catch the ball in traffic. And Randall Cobb, we're going to go with here, but primarily probably be going more skill players on the offensive side of the ball. Here we have to pick a lineman, and so what we like to look for here is impact block. The guy with the best impact block here, Josh Sullivan, is going to have that, so we're going to go with him. And we'll try and see here. Here we got an opportunity to get Kenny Britt with 89 catch in traffic, or Brent Celek, who has 81 catch in traffic, 84 run block. We're going to go ahead and go with Kenny Britt here. He's also 6'3" on the outside for us. So, quarterback here, I don't really like this Jameis Winston card. This Todd Gurley card, though, has 91 speed, decent truck rating, nice agility, but nothing too special here. William Hayes here, take a look at him. He's got 83 acceleration, 86 strength, pretty good power moves, so we're going to go with William Hayes here, and we'll rock with him. Next position here, we've got an opportunity to get another defensive end, or we can get Jimmy Graham. Jimmy Graham has 88 catch in traffic. He's 6'7". We're going to go with Jimmy Graham here. I think he's really good. I really like those bigger guys, those big catch in traffic receivers to go up and make those user catches with. So we're going to go with Jimmy Graham. As you see, Mario Williams has that 90 strength, 88 power move, 85 acceleration, but the 77 speed for my money is not what I really want to look for. So I'm going to go ahead and grab Jimmy Graham. Next, we have the opportunity to get a right tackle or quarterback and running back here. Frank Gore, really nothing I want to look for here. Eli Manning, you see here, has 79 deep accuracy, 89 throw power, 84 and 88. So really don't like either of these guys. This is kind of a pick that I really don't want to have to make. But we're going to go ahead and go with Eli Manning because we can handle, you know, not having him in our arsenal. So we'll go with him. Next opportunity here, we got a chance for a corner or a wide receiver, Eric Decker. We've already got Randall Cobb. Eric Decker, 93 catch in traffic. I really like that. But Jeremiah Ratliff here is probably where I'm going to go. He's got the 80 acceleration, 87 strength, 86 power move. You know, and I don't really put a whole lot of stock in having great corners this year. But Xavier Rhodes does have 91 zone coverage with 69 catch rating. So this is kind of a tough pick here. We're probably going to end up, Jeremiah Ratliff really doesn't fit what I want to do defensively with that 78 block shed. I need that to be a little higher, so we're going to probably go with Xavier Rhodes here, even though I don't normally take corners in the Draft Champions game mode. Next up here, we got an opportunity for some linebackers. Julius Peppers, look no further. I mean, this guy's got 87 acceleration, 83 strength. He'll be a really good player, but again, you see that block shed's not very good in the speed. He would be a good user player, but we don't normally user this linebacker. So let's look at Clay Matthews here, 74 zone coverage, almost 80 block shed, 81 speed. He's 6'3", so not as tall as Peppers is. 93 hit power, 74 zone coverage. Then we can flip him here and maybe take a look at his pass rush, and we're not able to, where he's going to be in the middle, so he'll be one of our backers that kind of runs around and makes some plays. Or we could get this guy, Denoris Searcy, but I don't really like his ratings. Nothing really stands out, no hit power, so we're going to go ahead and go with Clay Matthews here, the human hit stick. Next up, we have some opportunities here. James Jones is really good for us, 96 catch in traffic, 96 release rating. Ultron Werner, Glover Quinn really doesn't fit any mold for us. Ultron Werner does fit the mold for us really well with that 91 zone coverage and 77 catch rating. Glover Quinn, you see 91 zone coverage, 85 speed, 91 acceleration. Pretty good for what he's going to be doing, but we're going to go ahead and go with James Jones. In my opinion, we're going to have a really solid receiving core to go to with Manning, so we'll go ahead and go with that. Next up, we've got some options here. In this situation, we got Brent Grimes. Ryan Kerrigan is probably who we're going to look at getting here. You see this 85 block shed, 87 hit power, 81 speed, 86 acceleration. So pretty good ratings here for him. And I think he does have some decent pass rushing skills, if I remember correctly. So we're going to go ahead and go with Ryan Kerrigan in this situation. But you see, I like to build my defense from the ground up. I really like to get the good pass rushers and good things like that here. Here, Lance Briggs. Nothing really good looking from him. Stephen Tulloch, 74 speed. I mean, that's kind of a no-no right there. But not really good speed from these guys. So we'll look at this guy here, Gilmore. We'll look at the block shed of Briggs. Strength, acceleration is decent, 95 tackling. We're going to probably compare these two with the backside here. So let's see. 86 block shedding for Briggs, 87 hit power, 90 hit power for Tulloch. Pursuit, same. Speed is the same. Tackling goes to Briggs. Briggs has 82 acceleration. I don't know if they show me Stephen Tulloch's acceleration here. So in this situation, I kind of comes down to block shed, honestly. Those 2 points higher, and then the higher strength rating. I think we'll be able to get away here with Lance Briggs from the ratings perspective. He looks a little bit better, but we don't have that high hit power rating of Stephen Tulloch. Zone coverage, 75 for Tulloch. They don't show me Lance Briggs' zone coverage rating. So we're going to have to probably end up going with... This is a tough decision here. I don't really know who to pick. I'm going to go with Stephen Tulloch in this situation. And then next up, we've got right end Greg Hardy, Levante David. Levante David is an incredible athlete. Not a whole lot of strength in block shed, but 81 hit power, 98 pursuit. I mean, this guy's got 85 speed, 97 tackle. Really solid. Greg Hardy here has 82 block shed. Which is really not good enough for me. So we'll probably look at grabbing Levante David here. We'll have a really solid linebacking core. Probably throw Ryan Kerrigan on the end there. Levante David seems like the best option for us in this situation. Let's see here. Next up, we got the opportunity to get Justin Forsett, Larry Fitzgerald, Phil Rivers. We've already got a quarterback. I really, really would like to take Rivers here. The thing about Forsett is, again, nothing really that I like here. I mean, not really good speed or acceleration. Trucking's kind of low. I mean, he's just a nice agile back. But nothing really spectacular about him. Where's Fitzgerald here, 92 catch, 87 catch in traffic, 97 spectacular catch. We're going to go ahead and go with Larry Fitzgerald. And we're going to be passing the ball a lot with this offense here. Around 14 to 15. And here we get a nice option. We got Stafford would have been a great pick. Ingram has 87 trucking. We may have to end up just not having a whole lot of options running wise. We're going to go ahead and take Brandon Cooks here. I mean, 95 speed, 86 catch in traffic. We're going to have to take him here. Really solid, in my opinion. And here we get a legend. We're going to probably go with legend Terrell Davis since we don't have a running back. This would really complete the offense here. John Randall, 96 finesse moves, 90 block shed, 82 speed. Pretty solid there. But Davis has that 95 trucking. So we're going to go ahead and go with Terrell Davis here to round out our offense. And our offense is pretty solid. And then defensively this year, I don't feel like it's, you know, up to having like great players as so much as having great other things like that. So here we'll see. And I don't think you could actually adjust anything. So we kind of have to go into it as is. So we're going to go ahead and play our first game here. We'll play that for you guys. Got a decent team. And we'll see what we can do against our first opponent. But we'll see. Let's see here what we've got. We're going up against a pretty easy opponent. Looks like a mismatch. Not too good at the skill position, so we should be able to pull out a W here. Real quick while we're loading up, guys, I just want to call your attention to the description. I have a couple things in there that I'd like you to check out. I mean, if you're looking to get better in Madden 16, looking to get better offensively or get better defensively, I've got some really good products down there that you can check out that really have done a really good job of taking people and really making them successful at the game. You know, obviously you don't have to do that, but it is something that I would recommend you check out if you're looking to get better at the game. It's just something that you can use. It's really inexpensive in my opinion. The guides are very cheap. Compared to most players, most guys' guides, so you can check that out if you want to. If not, I completely understand. All right, so hop into game here, and the whole mentality for us today is we got to score. I mean, we should score on every single drive with this offense. I mean, this offense is really probably the best offense I've ever played with. I mean, the best offense I've ever put together. I mean, the only lackluster thing we have is Manning isn't mobile, but we got five receivers that are really good, and we got a really good running back, so we should be solid offensively. A lot of spread here, though. It's a good thing we picked that spread playbook, too, because we'll be in a lot of four wide receiver sets. So, let's see here. So hop in the game here. We got a 4-3 package. Open up. We're going to come out in the dollar. I've been liking the dollar here. And we'll see what we can do. We're just going to open up with some basic stuff. I mean, nothing too crazy. We're going to try to keep everything in front of us defensively. You know, just basic pressures, but keep everything in front of us. There's that hit power from Levante David. Got a nice turnover. So, all right, so hop into offense here. We need to score off the turnover for sure. I mean, this is really important. What I like to do, since we've got the spread, I think we're in the offense of the Dolphins here. Trey open offset. This will probably be the primary formation we look at. And we're going to try to start out small with the 56 trap. Get the ball in the hands of Terrell Davis. We got our big boys on the right side here, Jimmy Graham, James Jones. All those guys. There you see there's Davis powering forward for us and get a couple yards here. Offensively, we've got that nice center. And what I want to do is I'm actually going to make a quick substitution. I'm going to put my center as the pulling guard in that 56 wide trap so that he's going to kick that kick, get that nice kick out block. And, you know, he's kind of the main block that we need to hit. So we're going to have him in that position. And there's Davis. And there you see there's that nice trucking. Ooh, in this situation, we're going to go ahead and go play action. We'll throw one up to Larry Fitzgerald, let him try to make a play here. Throw a nice user catch up, let Larry Fitzgerald go up and make a play, a one-on-one situation. So pretty good opening start to the game for us. Really opened up strong. We'll go for two here. I like going for two here just to show you guys some more looks offensively. I like this ace pair of flex if we have the pitch. We do have the halfback toss. Those halfback pitches this year are really effective. We'll bring Cobb across. Get a nice kick out block here on the edge. We got some blockers. And use Terrell Davis as a nice acceleration to get us in the end zone. So, pretty good opening to the game. I mean, couldn't ask for much better. I mean, one play turnover defensively, offense scores with really no real lack. You know, no real tension from them. So, nice opening for us, and we'll see if we can keep it going. All right, defensively, like I said, I like to just, open up. I like to kind of just keep everything in front of me with this 3-2-6. And, I mean, he hasn't had the opportunity to even show me anything because we got that nice pressure. I like to send some basic pressure from this. You know, just some basic stuff. It doesn't always even work. But I like to play over-the-top coverage. Like I said, I just like to keep everything in front of me. What I find this year, and this is something that I saw on YouTube just kind of browsing around, but what I find this year is that putting your defenders in deep blue zones makes it really effective to put your linebackers in deep blue zones. It makes it pretty effective for run defense. And so, you know, I like to put those, I like to do some swaps. And basically what I do is I take the cover three shell and I switch it so that the linebackers are in deep zones and the safeties are in yellows, and then I play that over the top coverage, and then they it works out pretty well for me, especially opening up. I mean, it's an opening drive play. It's just something to get me in a, to keep the defense, or excuse me, to keep the offense in front of me. But I feel like it works out fairly well. I mean, what you'll see here is we'll get thrown here. The pressure is just something passive. I mean, it's passive pressure. But we see we do get a three and out here. I don't know if we're playing the computer. I think we are playing the. I think we're playing a user. So, pretty sure we are. We just loaded up said challenge. Right? So. All right. So here, get that punt return. But like I said, I mean, I like to keep it simple, especially opening up, just because of the fact that, you know, it's easy to make a lot of mistakes. You know, you try to do too much opening up. I mean, it's easy to make a lot of mistakes. You know, we've got a decent package here. We got some nice skill players on the outside to really take advantage of, and we'll be using a lot of Terrell Davis. So you could just book that. Terrell Davis, really good running back, does a lot for us, and in a lot of ways here. So he gave us a look for the counter last time. But see, counter. He didn't give us quite a look there. We do have that outside zone, so it may just be wiser just go ahead and come out in the counter. So we're going to need to change that. We'll put Sullivan at the other guard here so he comes on the outside with the counter. And then we'll have... Let's see, Sullivan needs to be here because he's got that great impact block, and then we'll put Jackson here. So we'll come out on the counter, and then we also have Sullivan on that edge for that outside zone. So here's a good look for the counter, so we'll take that and power it. Terrell Davis on the outside, get that first down with that nice truck rating. And what you're seeing here, I mean, this is simple. I mean, this is simple math. I'm actually going to change up my wide receiving core, though. I'm going to take Randall Cobb out. I'm going to have Brandon Cooks over there, so I'm going to put Brandon Cooks with that 95 speed, and then I've got Jones on the outside there, so really good offense here. In this situation, we'll go ahead and come out in the motion halfback swing here. Just try to get a simple play here. We're really aiming for 3 points. I mean, that's really all we're looking to get here. Here we don't get the look that I want, so what I'm going to do is play action read, and I'm going to bring Cooks on a little drag pattern across formation. A nice pat, and Manning gave me a really sucky pass, unfortunately there. So, but like I said, I mean, you know, part of the game is definitely, you know, knowing when to take your shots. You know, I'm convinced that, you know, sometimes it's not just about the big shot plays you have, but it's also about, you know, being able to know when it's wise to take your shots here. So in this situation. That was a terrible throw there. I think I threw it off my back foot, so that kind of hurt me. Alright, why corner? But like I said, I think it is smart to not just take shots, but to know when to take your shots, you know, more importantly. Here goes Mann. Nice catch by Jones there. A big catch for us. In this situation, this is something where we, like I said, we know that we have a nice option here to go ahead and take a shot, or not a shot, but to go ahead and go for it. And I don't really like this playbook, honestly. I mean, I think this is the Dolphins book, but we don't have a whole lot of options. We'll go ahead and wing trips. We'll look at that. This inside zone split. If we don't have that, we'll go ahead and audible out, but we're going to try to go to our bread and butter here with our money running back here. We put all that money into. We're going to go ahead and run the clock down just in case. That way he doesn't have as much time. So we'll go ahead and take the clock all the way down here. Like I said, this situation, we're just looking to power it straight down the middle, straight down the pipe, get the ball to Davis, let him make plays, and there you see he does come through for us. Now we'll start taking our timeouts. And now we're in two-minute drill mode. Like I said, we're trying to make sure that we score without giving him as much time. And I'm actually liking this formation a little bit better than the other one, so we're going to go ahead and stay with this. But what I like about it is the fact that we have seen some nice simple plays. Actually, I lied. I do like that other one because we have that nice wide corner. We'll go Trey open, though. And look at this fade smash here. See if we can't hit... I think we have Jones on that fade smash, so that'll be nice. So we're going to throw it up for Jones. I like the fade. I like the fade smash a lot. I'm a big fan of it. I like the way that they kind of... It's just a really good route. And one-on-one. There you see Jones mossing him. And we'll go ahead and take our timeout here. And instead of... And I wasn't really aware of the time. I should have taken another timeout. I was kind of lackluster on my part. But... you know, in this situation, it's really not wise to go ahead and try to get a touchdown. What we're trying to do early on in the game is we're trying to get up by a certain amount of possessions. You know, so it's always wise to, in this situation, we can go up by two possessions by taking that field goal. And so we're going to go ahead and do that. We'll go ahead and go up two possessions. I believe we do get the ball at halftime. So, you know, this is all about game management, clock management, in my opinion. And I think that's one of the most underrated things that people don't do in Madden. One of the reasons for a lot of losses is lackluster clock management. I know myself, I mean, that's probably 99% of my losses come from bad clock management or bad decision making. You know, in this situation, like I said, you know, we're up by two possessions. And so primarily, you know, we're looking to run the ball. We're looking to work the clock a little bit. I mean, we don't want to not be aggressive, but at the same time, we don't want to do anything stupid. And there's that outside zone, and Terrell Davis busts a big run. Like I said, you know, you can't take that for granted. You know, you're going to have a lot of opportunities to bust big gains, especially when you have a running back of his caliber. And so that's what we really took advantage of there. So good run by Davis to get us in the end zone. Sorry about all the notifications going off. I think my computer's, for some reason, forgot to silence it, so we'll take care of that for you. But in this situation, with it being 17-0, we're looking to go up by possessions. We can go up by three possessions, but three touchdowns if we get a two-point conversion here. So we're going to come out and go for two. In some situations there, we wouldn't, but like I said, you know, this situation, and it's all contextual, it's all situational in my opinion, but... you know, definitely an option here to get in for two. We're going to go back to this pitch. Got Robinson in the game now. Davis is getting a breather. Robinson's going to get outside. He doesn't have the same speed as David does, but luckily we go ahead and pound it in. We do have a good concept. You know, not always, you know, even though you have good, you know, even though you have good players, you have to have good concepts to put them in good positions. And so, is this situation 19-0. You know, defensively, we don't want to be too aggressive. I mean, we really don't. And this is, again, it's into the mindset of me. And what I find is that, you know, sometimes we just make the mistake of just being too aggressive and going away from what's working and things like that. And so you're going to see the same defense from me. I mean, I'm not going to change anything. And like I said, you know, over-the-top coverage. I mean, he hasn't given me any reason that I should come down and play this underneath stuff. He hasn't taken it. And, you know, this $326, I mean, like I said, it's a good package to just kind of fill your opponent out. I mean, I like to come out in it just to kind of get a feel for what my opponent likes to do. This is just something small. I mean, we're nothing too complex here. We're just, you know, like I said, we're just taking the grain with the salt here. See here, he's got open running lanes. And he's getting a couple yards here and there, but nothing too big, and that's the whole point. Is to just contain the offense, to keep everything in front of you. In this situation, third down and long, you know, we have an option here to maybe get a bad throw. And see, that's what I'm saying. You know, you had somebody open, but it was something small. We take away his bigger reads, the deeper down the field reads. We got to make him work for all their points. And I'm really into that this year, you know, making your opponent work for everything they get, you know, not just being aggressive and not just jumping stuff, and there is a place and time for that, but also having wisdom and having discernment of when to kind of step off the gas pedal and you know, coast into a turn or something like that. It's really, and really defensively, this is an art form that it takes me a lot of time and effort to really put into it, but defensively this year, I feel like I'm pretty solid, and simply because of those little bitty things that we take for granted. And as you see here, I mean, put us in a nice situation here now. In this situation, we're just taking his timeouts. I mean, we've got a 3-possession lead. You know, we're not going to pass the ball. We're gonna ground and pound. If we go 3 and out, it's okay. We're just looking to take that clock off. So we'll go ahead and get that chew clock mechanic on. And like I said, you know, this is cutthroat. I mean, we're trying to get out of here with a win. And you know, if he's going to give us this inside stuff with this counter and this running game, we'll go ahead and take that. Here we get outside, Davis, stiffies. I like the stiff arms this year. I'm starting to go away from the trucking. I haven't found too much success with the trucking yet. But what you're seeing here, I mean, this is just solid. I mean, this is solid game planning. You know, not a whole lot of big things done that, you know, really wow you. But taking advantage of our one-on-ones, using the players that we took, you know, picking our players strategically to know, you know, this is something we want to do offensively. We want to run the ball. We want to play good defense. Defensively, we don't want to be too aggressive. We want to be, you know, bend but don't break style. And, I mean, you're seeing right now we're doing pretty well. I mean, we've wrapped this W up, and we have done it really simply by just running the football and playing good defense. And, kind of getting down this situation with his timeouts. And this is where we can really kind of, you know, right now at this point, we've got it down 2 minutes. We can throw the ball here. And the reason is because if we score, the game's over. I mean, the game's pretty much over as is. But especially if we score. So we're going to, you know, be more aggressive here, more passing. But they're going to be simple passes. They're going to be over the middle. A lot of our passes are not going to be... you know, deep down the field, but more over the middle pass. And I think this guy knows he's got beat, and he'll probably go ahead and concede us the W. Make sure we take every second off that clock to get the game through as fast as possible. Stay behind our lead blocker too, and notice the substitutions we made with that guard, putting him in a situation where you know, he could really block for us and be effective for us. And so you see a couple of little bitty things, but you know, they've really netted a really nice result from us today. So but that's going to be pretty much the gameplay. You saw Terrell Davis, and it's just a power running game. I mean, really nothing too complex. I mean, we ran a lot of outside zones and counters based on the look that he gave us, and not too much complexity to it. But, you know, just being consistent, executing your game plan, all those things got us this win today. So thanks for watching, guys. Hope you enjoyed it. Like I said, if you want to get a little bit better, have some nice plays that you can utilize, some good playbook breakdowns. I got some really good stuff in the description for you with that Arizona offense, and in my opinion, the best defense on the planet right now, the New England Patriots defensive playbook. So